Shocking charges this hour out of Palm Beach County, Florida. Jupiter police say Robert Kraft, he's the owner of the New England Patriots, paid a prostitute for sex.
Yes, sir. He is one of the individuals.
Could you please name
who he is? That would be Mr. Robert Kraft.
Robert Kraft, the owner of the New England Patriots?
Yes, sir.
And what is he being charged with?
He's being charged with the same offenses as the others, and that is soliciting another to commit prostitution.
CNN's Jason Carroll reporting this story for us. Jason, what more can you tell us?
Really, this is an embarrassing moment for Robert Kraft, the 77-year-old billionaire owner of the New England Patriots. Again, just to recap here, Jupiter police announced today that he was charged with two counts of soliciting and another to commit prostitution. This is stemming from an eighth-month investigation that stemmed from Florida, also to China, and to New York. Apparently, what investigators are saying is he visited this day spa on not one, but allegedly two occasions. And according to what investigators are now telling us, he is among some 25 men who were arrested, again, for soliciting a prostitute. Again, this is the owner of the New England Patriots, a friend of the president. Again, much of the details of this coming forward to us now as this press conference now just wrapping up. But you're getting the headline there that Robert Kraft, owner of the New England Patriots, arrested for soliciting a prostitute at a day spa down there in Jupiter, Florida. We're efforting more information. As soon as we're able to get it to you, we'll pass it along. Back to you.
Jason, appreciate that. Our legal analyst, Paul Callen, joins us now on the phone. Paul, from what little we know so far, just give me your initial thoughts on this case and the high profile of an NFL team owner, the champion New England Patriots, being arrested in such a case.
Well, it's shocking, but on the other hand, John, it's not called the world's oldest profession for nothing. So this solicitation under Florida law is punishable by up to a year in jail. You can get a year of probation or $1,000 in criminal fines. They also have an interesting provision in Florida law that you have to complete 100 hours of community service and attend a prostitution and human trafficking awareness course. He's in for an embarrassing time. It's unusual that the John, which is what he is in this fact pattern, gets arrested. Usually the prostitute gets arrested or the person who's running the brothel gets arrested. So this is an unusual approach to go to round up the Johns. You see it happening periodically in jurisdictions where there's a major prostitution problem, and he just got caught in the net. So it's a really damaging thing to his reputation, obviously.
To that point, you heard the law enforcement briefing where they said Mr. Kraft was one of 25 men as part of this. So clearly the police seem to think that they had a major problem on their hand. Not trying to put context into this. I'm not sure how I would put context into this, but an organization, a business being used for a major operation that they decided they needed to make a statement here, right?
Absolutely, and send a message out in the community that they're not going to tolerate the operation of these spas that periodically become popular in urban communities around the country. So this is not unusual. It does happen all over the country, but it's a kind of a send a message arrest.
Paul, stay with us. Our Christine Brennan, a contributor who's also a sports columnist for USA Today, joins us now. Christine, Robert Kraft, as you know, I'm a Patriots fan. Full disclosure, I saw Robert Kraft over the weekend. I saw him Saturday and Sunday. I was at the NBA All-Star game in Charlotte, North Carolina, and he was there. We had a brief conversation, Mr. Kraft and my children, on an elevator and then in a hotel. When you see this, stay out. What's just your thought when you heard the news? We dialed you up. Robert Kraft arrested, alleged to have solicited prostitutes.
John, Robert Kraft is arguably the best known owner in sports. There's a few others out there too, but he's certainly in the top five, maybe in the top three in all U.S. sports. And so he has farther to fall than almost anyone. As you well know, he is one of the faces of the New England Patriots, and they have played in 10 Super Bowls. They have won a record tying 6 Super Bowl championships under Robert Kraft. So he is so recognizable, he is so well-known, and he really represents his franchise the way most owners don't, in the sense he's out front, very visible, and in Deflategate, very visible in that controversy several years ago. So the potential downside of something like this for Robert Kraft John, is even worse than it would be for most people because so many people know exactly who he is.
And to your point, he's an icon in New England for turning this, what was a moribund losing franchise around, but nationally known, A, because of the Patriots' success, B, because of his friendship with the President of the United States. The President of the United States has nothing to do with this, but the fact that he is known as the politics of this have come into play, that magnifies it. That's your point, right?
Oh, absolutely. But you're right. He has been a very vocal supporter of the president. You know, Robert Kraft, John, and again, you know this well from being someone who's followed Boston sports and New England sports for years. He is a very visible person. He doesn't shy away from taking stands, from being out there. A lot of owners in all sports tend to, some of them want to be out front. Others want to be behind the scenes. And Robert Kraft has always, as a 77-year-old who has always been in, out front and has always enjoyed the limelight and the spotlight, and sparring with journalists, and just being a guy who loves to represent his team. And this, of course, is the exact opposite kind of publicity that he would want. But because he is so well-known, now the scrutiny is there in a way that it wouldn't be for so many other people.
We'll keep our eye on the as the investigation plays out. Christine Brennan, appreciated. Patriots releasing a statement just moments ago. We categorically deny that Mr. Kraft engaged in any illegal activity. Because it is a judicial matter, we will not be commenting further. That from the New England Patriots about their owner, Robert Kraft.